Hello everyone, welcome to my talk. My talk is about how to use BPF trace with Performance Copilot and Grafana. So most of you probably know two or maybe three of the components, but for those who don't, I'll give a quick introduction. Performance Copilot is a system performance analysis toolkit. It consists of multiple components. One component are the agents. We call them performance matrix domain agents, and they are responsible to get a performance matrix from one source. For example, we have one agent for PostgreSQL, one agent for GlassFS, one agent for Microsoft SQL Server, and we have around 92 agents. And the latest new agents we wrote are one for BCC, that's the eppf compiler collection, and another agent to get metrics from ppf trace scripts. Each metric in Performance Copilot has multiple metadata associated with it. For example, the semantics. It can be either an instant value, like a temperature of the hard disk, or a counter. The Linux kernel exports a lot of metrics as counters that are monotonically increasing unsigned integers. So it just, for example, if you write something to a hard disk, the Linux kernel aggregates this data, and if you get two values, and you want the rate of, for example, how many kilobytes per second was written to one disk, you can just get two values, get the calculated difference, and divide it by the difference in time when you got these metrics. Then you have the rate. We also store a unit. It can be kilobyte, bits per second, whatever. So Performance Copilot always stores the data, how it gets them, for example, as a counter. And when the user wants to read the value, it automatically rate converts it. We also support multiple types, float, 32-bit, 64-bit, unsigned, signed integers, and strings. And also we have the concept of instances. For example, if you want to know how many bytes are written to a disk, then usually you have multiple disks, so each disk is one instance. And you can also, there are tools for visualizing the metrics in Grafana and as a Qt application. And there are also nice tools, for example, if you know that your application was working properly at 8 in the morning, but there was some issue at 10 in the morning, you can compare these two metrics automatically, and then it reports you the differences. And Grafana, it's a web application for the visualization of metrics. It supports visualization of time series data, of heat maps, of tableau data, world maps, and a lot more. It's highly customizable, so you can create your own dashboard. You click which type of visualization you want, for example, line chart. Then you select the query, which data you want, which metrics you want to visualize. You can select the legend, which lines you want, which color. You can hide something if you don't want some metric to be shown. And it also supports multiple data sources, for example, PCP, but also Elasticsearch, Prometheus, PostgreSQL, and I think around 10 more. And it's very extensible, so you can create your own plugins, you can create your own data sources, and also panels. Panels are the visualization part. And the nice thing, you can, in one dashboard, you can have multiple data sources. For example, you have one panel with PPF test data, and another panel you show data from PCP, for example, CPU usage, or you show data from Prometheus or anything else. And PPF trace, yeah, we just had a great introduction to PPF trace, so I'll keep it a bit short. It's a tracing language for ePPF. And in this example, we attach two trace points for the read syscall, and then we calculate when the read syscall starts, we save the current timestamp in a map. And then when the read syscall ends, we calculate the difference. So we know how much time was spent in the read syscall. And if you run PPF trace scripts, you start the script, then you wait for a bit so that the data gets sampled, then you close the script, and then you stop the script, and then you get for example, in this case, it's a histogram of the of all that data which was gathered while the runtime of the script. This is a heat map, a histogram. So you can see the bucket. The data gets grouped in BPFTrace in the kernel, so it's quite fast. And here, yeah, it's the lower bound is 256 in the first bucket, the upper bound is 512, and in the middle you see how many values fall in this bucket. And if you combine this with Grafana, basically you get another dimension to your data, you also get the time. So if you compare it here, this is the summary of all the runtime while you had the BPFTrace script running. And here it's one column is basically one heat histogram. So here in Grafana, if you have the dark theme, it's the darker shades are where less values are in a bucket. The buckets are always, for example here, 33 milliseconds to 66 milliseconds. And the lighter values are if there are more values in this bucket. So here we can see at the beginning, in the first around 10 seconds, there were a lot of values in this bucket, between 31 microseconds and 63. And the architecture of the full project is as follows. On the left side, we have the BCP part. There's this collector daemon, which collects the data from the agent. We call the agents in BCP performance matrix domain agent. And this BPFTrace performance matrix domain agent starts BPFTrace on the fly if you want data. And if the data is not requested anymore, for example, if you close Grafana, then it automatically stops BPFTrace. And PM proxy, the name is maybe a bit misleading. It started as a proxy, but it's now also, it's used for exporting the PCP matrix with a REST API, so you can access it through HTTP. And on the right side, we have the Grafana part. Grafana is actually not only a front-end application, it also has a daemon running called Grafana server. And you can configure it however you want. So either you want that the browser directly connects to PM proxy to get the matrix, or it goes through Grafana server. For example, if you are behind a firewall and you only have access to Grafana server, you can also let Grafana server proxy the request. And so if you open Grafana, it makes a request to PM proxy, give me the matrix of the BPFTrace script. Then it goes forward to the PMD, and if the script is not running, it starts it, and yeah, it gets the data. So how do you install this? On Fedora 31, unfortunately, the latest kernel, 5.4, broke a bit of stuff in EPPF land. The reason is that the Linux kernel gets compiled with GCC. The BPFTrace and BCC compiles the kernel headers with CLang. And GCC introduced ASM underscore inline, which CLang doesn't support. So there was the patch landed in BCC, I think, multiple weeks back. And for BPFTrace, I submitted a pull request 4 days back. So now it's in the master, in the upstream master, but it's not. There's no released version yet. But you can enable my Cooper, and then you have the latest BPFTrace version, if you use the latest kernel. It's also in Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8.2 in the beta. So in the beta, you don't need the copper. You just need the other parts. It's PCP, the PMD, Grafana PCP. That's the plugin for Grafana. So Grafana can speak to PCP and BPFTrace. And because BPFTrace needs to run its root, it needs a lot of privileges. And it can also execute other scripts, and it can also read files. So you have to configure authentication. You have two options here. Either you go with the BCP authentication, which is a bit difficult to set up, and it supports only SASL. Or you just set up, for example, an Nginx reverse proxy, because everything goes through HTTP, so you can just put a reverse proxy in front of it and use HTTP basic auth. Then you need to enable the PMD by going to this directory and installing it. For Grafana, you need to enable the plugin. So after you install it, in Grafana, you need to go to configuration and enable the plugin. And you need to configure a data source. So you go to data sources, enter the address of PM proxy. Usually the port is, yeah, it listens to all devices. Port is 44322. And last, I want to show you a few PPF trace tools. So there are a lot of finished PPF trace tools in the upstream PPF trace repository, example tools, and I'll show you a few of them. One of them is the CPU scheduler run queue latency. This measures the time, how much time a process is waiting for a CPU time. Here you can see if you write the PPF trace script directly in Grafana, you have a small code editor, you get auto-completion with trace points, you get auto-completion with PPF trace functions and built-in variables. And here the PPF trace script is like this. You have we attach to two trace points, and in the schedule switch, it's if there is a context switch happening, so the kernel is switching from one process to another. We're checking if the previous state was still running, so that means the process got interrupted, but it yet got interrupted and it wanted to continue to run. So we store when it got interrupted, and then a few lines below it in line 12, we check if the next PID, so the next process, if it got interrupted before, and if it was, we print a histogram. And in Grafana, we see it like this as a heat map again. So we can see at 19, 56, and 45 seconds, there were a few processes waiting on CPU time around between, this is the lower bound, this is the upper bound, between 1 and 3 microseconds. Other PPF trace tools write the output not as a histogram, but just in a console, so in the terminal. For example, TCP connect, it tracks all the TCP connection requests in the kernel, doesn't matter if it's successful or not. And the original tool just prints them in a console like this. It also prints a source address, but redacted it for privacy, for the IPv6 addresses. And if you want this in Grafana, you can also do that. You need to do a bit of changes, so instead of padding the output with spaces, you just do it with commas so that I can parse it properly and make a table. And with this script, usually it just keeps on running until you close it, so it gets the list of connection requests gets bigger and bigger. That's why I created a small metadata annotation for the PMD that it just should only keep 10 entries in the table, and the rest of the data, the older values should be just cleared out. This is the rest of the PPF trace script. I redacted a lot just so you can see the CSV output. And in Grafana, it's a table. In Grafana, you can customize everything. Here it's sorted by time. You can remove columns, And it gets refreshed automatically. You will see it in the demo in a few minutes. And with PPF trace, you can also sample kernel stacks. This example, I'm 99 times per second. I'm saving the current kernel stack in a eBPF map, and I'm counting it. So if I sample the same stack multiple times, yeah, I can see how many times it got sampled. And with this information, I can print flame graphs. So flame graphs are, it's kind of a reversed stack trace. So on the top is the actual kernel function, and the lower you go up, and the next one is like the parent. And the x-axis is not the time, it's just the more stack frame got sampled, the bigger the box gets in the x-axis. So this, the raw spin unlock gets sampled a lot, and yeah, event write and finish task switch. And if you want to try it out immediately, I configured I created a container with all the dependencies included. You just run it with the latest kernel. You don't need the kernel sources anymore because the kernel headers are already included in the kernel. It's just for older kernels. And you can start it at port 3000. You should take care that you only allow it to listen on localhost because I disabled authentication, and yeah, otherwise every unauthenticated user can execute PPF trace scripts. Let's see how it looks. When you install the Grafana PCP plugin, you get a few dashboards, which I prepared. And if you start a dashboard, here we can see four BPF transcripts. So you start it, the BPF transcript got started in the background, and it's plotting the data. The, if you remember the CPU run queue latency program, we can see here are the settings of the panel. Here is the code editor. It's the original BPFTrace tool from the, the example tool from the BPFTrace repository. There's all the code and there's the visualization. You can also, for example, here's the block latency. And if we generate some load, you should see a bit of change. You see the white boxes because I just writing a few bytes on my hard disk. And if I stop the script, it should get dark again. Yes. So, yeah, I think now we have time for questions.
Can we use that tool to export the metrics or to send the metrics to Kafka and import it in a time series database?
We have the PCP supports an open metrics endpoint. That's the format also Prometheus uses. And if you can read this file, it's through an HTTP endpoint. If you can read open metrics format, then you can have it. And also PCP supports writing the data to a Redis database. It's a recent feature. So you can also write it to Redis directly. But probably in your case, probably if you read the open metrics format, it's probably best. And because it's integrated in PCP, you can use all the PCP tools. It's PCP metrics, you can all the tools which are written for PCP, which are a lot, like comparing different archives, logging it, and predicting it and responding to events.
Can this also run on archives, or is it just live?
Yeah, if you configure PM Logger to store it in an archive, it gets in an archive. It's a normal PCP metric. You can do everything what you also do with PCP metric.
Thanks.
Any more questions?
Thanks. that would be very elementary question, but what actually is PCP? I tried to Google it, but I only find some drugs.
Yeah, the PCP is the abbreviation for Performance Copilot, and the project got started in 1993. It's a pretty old project. It was previously closed source only for SGI, and then they open sourced it. It also works for FreeBSD and stuff. But it's basically, it reads a lot of metrics, for example, from slash proc file system or other agents. It stores the data. You can store it in archives. And it's very helpful, for example, support engineers at Red Hat. If a customer has a performance problem, they install it. The tool keeps collecting the data on the customer's server. And then the support people can gather the data, see it locally, and then can hopefully see what caused the problem. Because usually, if there's a problem, the customer calls the support employees, and then usually the customer says, yeah, the problem was at 5 in the night or something. So it stores also historical data, and we can analyze the data. And there are also scripts. If the customer says, yeah, it worked perfectly fine at 8 in the morning, there was a 10, we had some issue, we don't know what was it. And then maybe the our support engineers can deduct, huh, there was, I don't know, something, there was some log contention going on or some other issue. So, yeah, if you Google it, you should Google it for Performance Copilot, the full name. Yeah.
We still have 5 minutes. Anyone else has a question?
can also show the tables. Here we have the TCP connect. So if I make a TCP connect to the Cloudflare DNS server, we should see, yes, here in the TCP connect, we see that I just entered a curl process and it connected to the destination address 1.1.1.1 at port 80. And I have SyncThing running, which is a great tool. Yeah. These are a lot of different BPF trace tools. Except it's empty because nobody's connecting to my server. And the other tools are all the TCP sessions, file system links. This is, for example, which cores of my processor got utilized. I have 8 virtual cores, and it keeps on refreshing. And if I close the browser, after 1 minute, all the BPF trace scrubs gets stopped automatically. And you can configure the timeout where you want.
Okay, I see there are no more questions. Thank you.